Welcome to the Quintin and Ramenia Show, where Christianity is an action, it's not a noun. I'm Quintin.
And I'm Ramenia.
And our topic today is local businesses new and unfamiliar in the Miami Valley. Today's new business is the seafood restaurant, S-E-E-F-O-O-D, restaurant, and 6556 Union Road in Clayton. And our guest we have here is Ms. Verlean Morris.
Yes.
Would you say hello to the audience here?
Hello, audience.
Verlean comes to us here in the Miami Valley from Arkansas by way of Pasadena, California.
Wow. Yes.
So just to give us a little history, why Dayton? Why'd you come here? And you came from great wealth in the area.
Great
good
wealth.
Distance.
Great wealth. Well, actually we had a little business in a small little shopping mall in Palmdale, California.
Okay.
We opened in 2004, and as we all know, by the time we got to eight somewhere in there, the market started to crash.
Mm-hmm.
Business got really slow, and everybody was losing everything, and people actually couldn't find jobs at all.
Mm.
You know, so you have to have like a couple of DDDs and degrees behind your name to be able to survive.
Gotcha.
So I have relatives out here, and my husband does as well. And when we relocated, we at least was able to find work.
Okay.
And he started working at different factories out here, and we was able to, you know, buy a home, and you know what I'm saying, we was able to live.
Yeah.
Whereas there, if y'all know anything about California,
the cost of living is high.
The cost of living is sky high.
Yes, it is.
So that was a major leap for me. I felt like I was in Oz.
Oh.
And I kept trying to find my red slippers. But now I have adjusted and I love it here. It's home, I like the pace here. And the people here, and I'm good. And,
okay.
You know, like my family moved out here, my immediate family moved out here as well. Like, you know, one by one, they came. And my grandchildren are here, and we good.
Oh, beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful.
Yeah. It is a different pace.
Absolutely.
Out here, because I'm originally from Pittsburgh, but I come here by way of Sacramento.
Okay.
And I was in Rancho, which is a suburb of Sacramento, and when I first moved here, it was like, this is really not the place for me. And then I went back home for 2 months, and I was ready to come back here. And
yes.
I've been appreciative
here
ever since.
The lack of traffic.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
and
my.
Again, the cost of living is just
living.
Ridiculous.
Yeah. That's major. That's major.
So it makes a big difference. So, yeah, I can relate to it.
Absolutely.
Southern California is known for movies, theaters, amusement parks, and all of that, but it's mainly known for its food.
Yes.
In areas. And I know the earthquake just occurred there. Was that before you got here, or was it after you got here?
Which earthquake?
There was an earthquake in that area.
No, you've been here for a while, right?
Yeah,
okay.
We've been here for going on 11 years now.
Okay.
So
there's earthquakes all the time. I mean,
so
you make
one.
A step, you miss one.
Gotcha.
So,
gotcha. Okay.
You know,
all right.
It's like people don't notice half the time when there's an earthquake.
Wow.
Unless it happens like early in the morning when people are sleeping.
Because
if they happen so fast, but you lift your foot up, one happened, you don't know it happened. You know, unless it's like 6 point something or whatever.
Right.
Okay.
Big. But
okay.
It's always shaking out there.
Okay. Now, before we came on the air, you were talking to one of our cameramen about the tornado, how it affected you.
Mm-hmm.
That occurred right here in Dayton. We had previously had on our other episode, we had two guests to come in, and they were right in the heart of it, of one funnel, and they would be back again. So how did it affect your business, and then just go right into when you got started and so on and everything concerning the business?
Well, the tornado affected us because we had a lack of power and water. And we couldn't even get to our business because of all the damage around us because we live in Trotwood, and the business in Clayton, which is nothing, it's only like down the street, but we couldn't even get down the street because of all the trees and the debris and the loss of people's properties.
Right.
So it affected our business directly because we couldn't open, and then again because we lost all our inventory.
Wow.
But we couldn't get in there for 9 days.
Wow.
Ooh.
So all our produce, all our fish, everything, you know, just we got directed some other wares. We couldn't get, that's them couple of miles. We couldn't, it was so much damage.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I'm just grateful that it did not destroy our home or even the structure of the building where the business is.
Right.
So that was major. I mean, I actually slept through it. Believe that I slept through the
us
whole
too.
Thing.
Yeah,
I woke up to people texting me, telling me, "Are you okay?" I'm like, "What is wrong with everybody? Why am I supposed to be okay?" You know,
right?
Then
right.
I found out with lack of power and lack of anything, it was, you know, people. My phone was still working. That's how I found out that it actually happened. Mm-hmm. I didn't have no electricity when I woke up.
Okay. So, now you said you started the restaurant 4 months ago, or it's 4 months old.
Yes. What? August 8th will be 4 months.
All right.
Okay. Yes.
So what gave you the decision to have a restaurant that you have and the menu?
Well, we decided that we was going to do it again because my husband always had this idea of doing this restaurant again because we didn't complete what we were doing in California because of the market.
Okay. Right.
So we found that little place right there, that location, and he was like, "This is the perfect location. It's like this city over across the street and that across that street."
Right.
Back behind us, you know, and it's like different people, different, you know, communities all in one place.
Right. Yep.
This corner right here is, you know, got all these different people. And I was kind of annoyed, personally, from being out here, like everywhere I went to eat food, for the most part, it wasn't as good as mine. So
nothing wrong with that.
So, and then a lot of them is not like, it's not homemade.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So that's very important to me. I mean, I love food. Look at me. Don't I look like I love food? And I love to cook. And I take it personal. When it ain't right, I really do. I take it personal. I mean, I don't complain a lot, but I do.
Right, right.
I take it personal. I mean, I would like somebody to make something. I'd be like, "Oh, they put that in there. They ain't gotta tell me. I know, you know.
Yeah.
Right.
Kind of know.
Right.
Like,
yeah.
Oh, they put too much of that, or I don't, you know, make a big deal out of it. But I appreciate that, and because I really enjoy, like when we met.
Yes.
I enjoy it because I know that I love what I do.
Yes.
So you're gonna know that.
You do know that. In the taste of the food, you definitely know that.
Yes.
And then to be able to have you come in and stop at the table and interact with us, I mean, that was awesome too, because a lot of restaurants, you don't get that either. You may get a manager come by and say, "How is everything?" But you stopped and had a full-blown conversation.
You don't see a manager normally unless there's a problem.
Right.
Right. Right.
But my whole concept about food is comfort. I want you to feel comfortable. I want you to feel like you just a dollar bill.
Right.
I want you to feel like you're welcome for real.
Right.
Uh-huh. And I want to sit there and watch you eat that. And I did that, didn't I?
Yes, you did.
And
like,
then
you feel very comfortable.
Go ahead.
And then as you're telling us the other, I really, really enjoy banana pudding.
Mm-hmm.
So It's kind of rough to walk away without it.
Mm-hmm.
When
we were
said
full.
You made some, but
we were
the
full.
Smothered pork chops just took me there.
Okay.
So, you know, there was no way I was going to be able to eat any banana pudding. So I'm going to have to come back.
You're going to come back.
Because I love it.
I'm making a fresh batch of it in 2 days. I'm waiting on my bananas.
Okay.
Oh. So I'm not going to just put it out there when I know it ain't ripe.
And
enough.
I love that.
They got to be ripe enough.
Yes.
So I tell the people, look, I mean, I'm not going to just feed it to you because I want you to want it, but it's got to be right. I'm not going to give you no bananas that's not ripe enough.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I got to wait. I'm sorry.
Because that's what makes people keep coming back.
Yes, absolutely.
For it. But those mother pork chops, and I'd even tasted his oxtails. Y'all, Wednesday special is oxtails.
Yes.
Smothered pork chops.
Mm-hmm.
And them smothered pork chops are delicious.
Mm-hmm.
And them oxtails, because I had never had oxtails before. My mom used to make them when I was little, but you know, certain things that she really liked, she didn't mind if we didn't want none, and I was one of those who didn't want none. So she never made me eat them. So I never had them, but I know that he likes them.
Mm-hmm.
So I was thinking, I gotta learn how to make some oxtails. But when we saw them on the flyer when your husband was passing them out,
uh-huh.
I was like, oh, okay. So to come and you still have some?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Excellent.
Yes, I enjoy doing everything I do. And that I really do. It's like, it's not a problem for me. You know, mm-hmm. some people are like, oh, I gotta go to work. Well, I don't be feeling like that. And I have a lot of, like, you know, little issues going on within my, you know, my body or whatever,
mm-hmm.
my mobility. But I get my little stool and give me my things that I need. And mm-hmm. it's like I got my own assembly line, and I get in my zone, and hey, it's going down.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I'm done doing whatever I got going down, I come out and I greet my guests
mm-hmm.
and be like, okay, hey, here's it right here. Go on, get in there. You know, try that out.
Oh.
Go ahead.
Yeah, yeah, that was good.
I had this one gentleman said, he said that he didn't like collard greens, he says. So I said, well, do you like greens at all? He was like, yeah, I like greens, but I ain't never found a collard green I like. I said, okay, well, just wait right there. I went in there, and I got him a little taster cup. And I would kind of fight with him a little bit, just taste them. But I went and got a little cup, and I gave him a fork, and I said, taste these. And he tasted them. He's like, man, these are really good. He said, add some of those to my order and give me one of those to go. You know what I'm saying? So that right there, it makes my job worth it to me.
Mm-hmm.
You know
mm-hmm.
what I'm saying? I said, well, he been born again. I was telling everybody. I said, this guy, he said he don't eat nobody's greens. He don't mess with the glory greens in the can or none of that. That's mm-hmm. why I ain't got nothing in no can up in here. I don't mm-hmm. do that. We don't do that at all. Not at all. So, yeah, and I've had a lot of experiences like that where people didn't eat certain things. I never had an oxtail. I hear that a lot. I'd be like, well, I got to taste this. Then now they're eating oxtails, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So that is, you know, it's a lot of fun to me.
Those will definitely bring you back. But
yeah.
Everything that we had the day that we came in was delicious. And the icing on top of the cake was getting to meet you and watch you interact with us. Because,
yes.
again, you don't always get that.
No,
at
never.
A big restaurant, sometimes even at small restaurants,
right.
because we with the radio show and even with doing radio sales and all, we have gone to different restaurants and things and mm-hmm. made deals with different people to give them get them on the radio and stuff for ads and all. And unless you're actually dealing with them in that aspect, you don't really always see.
Right.
Manager, like you say, you don't necessarily see them unless there's something going wrong.
Right.
And you just walked in the door, and as you walked in the door, stopped at our table and just started talking to
mm-hmm.
us. And that, the food is good, but that's what keeps folks
yeah.
coming, because no matter how good your food is, if the atmosphere
right.
isn't set with that as well, I mean, your servers are good. Your husband came over
mm-hmm.
to the table and talked to us.
Yes.
I mean, it was just awesome.
Well,
the atmosphere is awesome.
We appreciate that. We appreciate that.
So give the address.
Now, our time is running, and we were supposed to have your husband here. But can you tell us why your husband is not here?
We got a dinner rush, and we both were trying to get it out, and our cook was all in there, you know, juggling plates and orders. So one of us had to stay behind.
Mm-hmm.
And
But dinner rush is a good thing.
Yeah.
Dinner rush is a
yeah.
good thing.
With that being said, the prices are awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Enough for you to have a dinner rush. And this is Tuesday.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
This is not Monday. It's not Sunday. And what happens on a Sunday? You all have a what?
Sunday brunch
yes.
from 11 to 3. Ooh. And the special on Sunday is gumbo.
Oh.
Yes. And then, of course, we have the fish and the chicken and the all those delicious homemade sides and pies and cakes.
Okay.
Yeah, the people at the table by us had gotten the fish, and it looked delicious, too.
Okay.
So.
Yes. It's the best in town.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, you are, which brings us to our next thing. Because you're kind of crowded right now at the moment that we are doing the show. What kind of accommodations do you have? What's the capacity there, and you know, what do you host?
Well, we have this one, it's like two sections in there.
Mm-hmm.
And I think what they were gonna do before we leased the place where they were gonna have a comedy club on one side and a bar on the other, but we don't have the bar because we don't care about the liquor part anyway. Mm-hmm. So the part that was going to be the comedy club, we can also have social gatherings there. Mm-hmm. And in that room there, it seats about 100 and maybe 120 people.
Okay.
And then the other side, it seats about 30, maybe 40 people.
Okay.
And in that, the room that was going to be the comedy club, we have a comedy show once a month there with local comedians.
Okay.
And the next one's August 31st.
Okay.
August 31st, comedy show.
7 o'clock.
What time?
Okay. 7.
7 p.m.
$10 is the, it's $15 for the entry.
Okay, $15
and
entry.
Buy a meal. So you got about $30 for an evening out and laughter and good food. Promise you that.
And excellent portion sizes
excellent
of
portion
the food.
Sizes. Mm-hmm.
Definitely.
Yes. And we have a lot of fun. We have a lot of fun. It was really the last one that we had a lot of laughs. This time it's three ladies that's going to be there. I can't remember their name. I'm old. But
no, you're busy.
That part, too. Yes. But, yeah, so far in there we've had two baby showers in this particular room and probably like 80 to 100 people. And we also had a gender reveal party. We hosted that, and we hosted a baptism something. Somebody's child got baptized at a ceremony, whatever, there. And then, like I said, the comedy shows in there. So, I mean, if someone needs the accommodations, then they can contact me directly, and we can set something up, see what we can do.
Okay, so how do they get in contact with you directly? Do they instant message you on Facebook, or would that be better?
Yes.
Okay, so I hope you all got the Facebook page up. That's M as in Mary, Z as in Zebra, V as in Victor, E-E, V's Seafood, S-E-E-F-O-D, a restaurant on the Facebook page. So look that up, and if you haven't liked it yet, you need to.
Yes.
Because you will be liking it for the food, and you'll be trying to find out what a recipe is, and you'll be trying to find out what they're serving that day, and everything else, and you'll walk out full.
Definitely.
And I had to force my desserts on people because they be so full. That's a shame.
No, that's a good thing.
Yeah,
that's a very good thing.
Because
then
thing.
We could take out the dessert, but okay. We weren't even able to take out the dessert the other day. So, we'll get there.
Okay.
Yeah, actually, I had told him, well, we gonna have her on in about 2 weeks, so we gonna have to come there and try a bunch of other stuff. So we know.
Okay. All right.
But I mean, again, the food is delicious.
Thank you.
The atmosphere is wonderful. I mean, everybody there was wonderful. The mm-hmm. waitress that waited on us, the other waitress that was there working, your grandbaby came in,
yes.
helping
mm-hmm.
you carry stuff. Your husband came over, talked to us. You spoke with us. I mean, even, I think it was the cook that brought my fried okra out
mm-hmm.
to me. I mean, the whole atmosphere is just a nice place to go.
Appreciate
and have
that.
Dinner
we appreciate
or lunch because we came for lunch. So I mean,
felt like
it's
dinner.
Just, well, yeah, because we didn't eat that. That's the rest of the day.
I'm sure you
so,
did.
It was over.
But I mean, it was delicious, and we are so glad to have you in the community.
I appreciate it. I really do. I appreciate it. It kind of gives me, like, it makes me be the social butterfly that I am to mm-hmm. be able to interact with people, because coming here from California, I didn't really mm-hmm. know a lot of people,
right.
you know.
Mm-hmm.
And this way I'm meeting a lot of folks from all over the place, and I get to interact just because I like to do it. I like to interact with people, you know, always have. So I get to go to work and cook, which I enjoy, talk to people I enjoy. So I'm just having a good time. I don't even realize time be gone. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? The day be gone so fast, but I have a good day.
We need to connect you with Clayton has a food tasting.
Taste of Clayton, Meadowbrook.
Okay. And we were there for, and they had some nice little snacks and so on, but because you're right there at the border and you're on the other side of the golf course, we'll connect you with Jack Kuntz, who is the director of that area. So, and get prepared because they charge, but it's all about advertising in the community, and you're right there on the border. Right there on the border.
And they have a really good turnout for that as well.
Extremely large turnout. Extremely large turnout. For those of you who are still trying to remember, that 6556 Union Road Clayton Seafood Restaurant with Miss Verlean Morris. Make sure you come. And you might see us there eating dessert because there's ice cream right next door. So we get the dessert, get the ice cream, and, you know, then we walk
just
away.
Just give me the banana pudding.
Either or. Just give me the pudding. Any last words before we finish our show concerning your restaurant?
I'm just really happy to be here. I appreciate you inviting me. And I'm here representing my restaurant, which I love, and I enjoy what I do again. And I love feeding folks, so y'all come on out. Come on out and eat. Just come by and have a conversation.
Yes. All right, all right.
You might be running me away. They say I talk too much.
Maybe we'll have your husband. Maybe we'll have your husband along with you the next time.
All right.
Does he cook? Okay.
Well, actually, he can do the fish and the chicken wings, the deep fryer stuff.
Man stuff, right.
I'm sure he works the grill.
Yeah,
I don't do the grill too. Like that, but we'll leave it at that.
Yes, he does. So we be in there juggling, you know what I'm saying? I have my thing that I don't really mess around with the frying the fish and stuff like that. I my thing is basically the baking and making those sides.
Yeah.
You know, which, nah, he don't do all that. He does man stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
Real quick, before we get off the air, you mentioned the fish. Is there a certain time that you have a certain type of fish, or is that just every day?
Every day.
Okay, and your hours are?
11 a.m. We usually to supposed to be out of there at 11, but I don't think people in Dayton hang out that late. So it starts getting really quiet around 9:30, 10-ish. So when it stopped, then we stop.
Okay.
If somebody come in at 10:01, we got them.
Okay.
So far,
this how it's been, though.
Okay. Well, after this show, you'll have quite a few.
Yeah, all right.
Oh, definitely.
That will definitely work.
We'd like to thank you for joining us. Again, we're going to try to get your husband on. And because you had a rush, that was good. We thank you for joining us here at Quintin and Ramenia Show. And as we always end our broadcast, based off of Mark 9:23, if thou canst believe, all things are possible to those that believe. We love you.
Yeah.
That was your line.
No, my line was see you later, alligator.